Hey, what's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Jacob Restituto, and I'm a musician from Northport, New York. And today we're continuing along in the ninth track. We are doing Ariana Grande, Demi Lovato. Met him last night. I had a lot of requests for this one, so I'm looking forward to seeing the production. I read the lyrics, very interesting lyrics. But I want to hear the production. So let's get right into it. As always, if you're a musician yourself and you want to release your own music, just like I release my own music, you want to check that out, definitely consider checking out DistroKid. I'll link in the description where you can save 7% on your first year's subscription. Put your music on Apple Music, Spotify, Pandora, TikTok, all the great platforms. Keep 100% of the royalties. They send you a check or direct deposit or however you do PayPal, whatever you want. It's really cool. I'll leave a link in the description. You can save 7%. This is Met Him Last Night. Oh, nice tremolo. Interesting. So there's two synths you're hearing, that arpeggio, da 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 da, chord change, da 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 da, and that's panning back and forth, but then there's also these swells that are coming in, a little bit more pan to the left, where the other one is panning back and forth. Yeah, swelling chords. That's called a slow attack. So for example, if you see some sort of synthesizer like this, these knobs up here, or at least on mine, the top knobs, are attacked, decay, sustain, and release. And the two more main important ones that we'll talk about right here are the attack and the release. Attack is how fast a sound comes in. So like, hey, has a very, or even like it could be long, like, hey, has a really long attack, or really fast attack, as opposed to, hey, hear how the same thing, but just one was quieter and they got louder. That's a slower attack. Release is how long it takes for the sound to go out. So like, if I would be like, hey, short, fast attack, and fast release, as opposed to hey, as opposed to hey. See how it was loud, fast came in, and then slowly came out after. That's a slow release. So you can hear the synthesizer. It's coming in instead of being like a piano, which would be a fast attack. It's some sort of synthesizer that has a slower pan. It swells in. Didn't know you were gonna get a whole lesson on ADSR. I like that panning. You pour another, say it's fine. Hear the slapback echo giving a little bit more extra fullness and a little extra depth to her vocals. Wow. Dude, those harmonies are insane, man. Yeah, I met him last night. Had conversation. Yeah, I think he's alright. Seemed kind of funny. Yeah, he kind of my type. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, hear the arpeggio coming in, walking down like that. Oh, interesting. That kind of sounds like the Selena Gomez, kind of almost this like pull out, like almost the noise gate, like the really fast closing, fast release on the vocals, pulling them out, which is really cool, actually. She has a very distinct voice, Ariana, but the way the production and the way that melody could have been like a Selena Gomez melody. Oh, ping pong. Those harmonies are crazy. I'd like to hear your opinion on this. So there's a lot of like metaphors in this album, obviously, and the way she does these lyrics. So I'd love to know your opinion and what your thoughts are on what the meaning behind this. Because I have a feeling. Obviously, we know that so far this album has been about her drug habits and the overdose and the relapse and the coming back from that. But this is one that's very interesting. I'm assuming it's some sort of metaphor because it sounds like she's in a bar and like, you know, it sounds almost like she's talking about a guy, and I'm just not under, obviously she's referencing the devil, but I don't know if like she's using that as a metaphor, or if she's talking about like drugs as a metaphor of the devil, or like, you know what I mean? I'm just not entirely understanding the context of this. And I'd love to know your opinion, because you guys seem to know way more about this stuff than I do.
Had conversation, yeah, I think he's alright. Seem kind of funny, yeah, he kind of my type.
I was looking at the lyrics, actually. I pulled them up yesterday when I was looking at the lyrics. Let me see if I can pull them up again. So, here we go, perfect. See, isn't history the best thing? Let me show you some of the lyrics. So what's interesting is, like, I'm pulling up the lyrics. Like, I've seen the devil, met him last night, had a conversation, think he's all right. It seemed kind of funny, kind of like, but one, when you, she was going through the lyrics, like, she talks about, like, and that's, like, you know, how the devil is described is very often as this, like, you know, kind of, there's a slight truth to every lie, you know, and, like, kind of very deceptive and very, you know, kind of seems all right, doesn't seem like a bad idea. It seems like it's a kind of a good idea in the moment, or slightly, you know, but it's always slightly perverse from the truth, you know, and it's just enough to get you off from the truth. And it's just interesting, like, how she describes that, like, you know, and then she goes, and though I think it ain't right, and then she's saying, I won't let it happen again, realizing almost like, hey, you messed me up, I won't let it happen again, this is the last time you won't take advantage of the innocence. And it's just interesting to see, like, almost this, like, deception that she received, and, like, trying to, like, almost redeem it. This is like, I don't want it to happen again. But I don't understand the lyric, I don't believe in you, which is interesting. Like, I don't know, these are very interesting lyrics that she has, I don't know, I'd love to know your opinion of it. Let's keep going on the track. Harmonies are insane.
Could be so deceiving. Boy, you were my only vice. I never feel this way. Told me no hostage, I'm leaving. Boy, you just gave me a reason. No, I never thought I'd be the one. No, I never thought I'd be the one to fall. Watch me fall before I give you my all. So I promise tonight is the last call.
Interesting. Okay, that's really interesting. So Genius is not very helpful, and usually Genius is amazing because they give you a lot of insight. Let me pull actually the screen back up. So, you were my own. This is interesting. It's almost like she's personifying the devil as a person, but almost as a drink too, is kind of how I'm getting it. Because listen to this, and I don't know if I'm crazy and reading too far into it. How could that one look could be so deceiving? Kind of what I was saying earlier. You are my only vice. Often, like alcohol and stuff, drugs are talked about as being a vice. Won't be no hostage. Like, you know, addiction keeps you hostage. And then, here's the last line that I want to talk about. Promise tonight is the last call. Obviously, that can be taken as, like, oh, you're calling a guy or calling a girl kind of thing. But last call is something that happens at a bar. And it's like when you're at the end of the bar, at the end of the closing night of the bar, 3 a.m. or whenever the bar closes, they say, okay, last call. Very interesting. And it's, I don't know, I'm very intrigued by this. But, like, there's literally no insight except for the fact that there's this one thing right here from Genius, which if you put it on, it's like, it's literally the yeah. And it's saying, oh, Ariana posted about this on Instagram. And then there's one more thing where it's, like, talking about wine, which is very interesting.
Kind of pulling back almost to a halftime feel right here, given with just a snare on the two.
Dude, you have some two huge powerhouse vocalists on this. It's insane how talented both of these ladies are vocally. It's so intimidating as a singer, like, to hear these just insane vocals.
But it's really interesting. This was very interesting, the personification, because like, and throughout the whole thing, she's like, it's almost like, and I might be reading too far into this, and I'd love to know your opinion. Like, she's confused. Like, oh, it looks good. The person, quote unquote, looks funny, looks great. You know, it looks like a good time. But then she's talking about being deceived and not wanting to be deceived again. And it's just, that makes a lot of sense. And, you know, in reference to the devil, in reference to drugs, in reference to a lot of things that seemed like a good idea at the moment. And then you realize, oh, this was not a good idea, but now it's too late to stop. Or it's just very, very interesting. And I would really like to know your opinion. So let me know in the comments below. Let me know your theories or if she spoke about it. So I'll see you guys in the next video. Thank you so much for watching. If you did enjoy this, definitely subscribe. Type in Jacob Restituto, Demi Lovato if you want to see the rest of this stuff. And if you want to check out my music, it means so much to me. I'll see you in the next video. God bless and peace out.